What a matchup we have in store. It's still early in the season, but this is a major test for a couple of squads who've gotten out of the gate undefeated. As we'll see, a squad from Conference USA, the UTEP Miners, facing a fellow Conference USA opponent, the Liberty Flames. For EA Sports College Football, Reese Davis with you alongside David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. Time to get this game started. And the Flames will kick it away to start us off. If you can do that, I don't know why you don't do it every time. Reduce the risk. Bang it out of the back of the end zone. They'll put it in play at the 25. Okay. Here comes the offense on first down. Wide receiver coming across in motion. Quarterback touch pass on the jet sweep. He's off to the races. And an explosive play has him on the move, and he gets it all the way to the 48-yard line.
I love that play call, and I love the timing of the pre-snap motion. Because the quarterback was able to get it to the receiver right behind the offensive line, because of the timing, he was able to outflank the defense. That puts him out in space where he's able to use his speed. Nice job with the pre-snap motion and timing.
On the ground, it's Jackson. And they try to run inside, and there is nowhere to go.
It's an offense that takes pride in being physical. They try to get it going on the ground, but no gain on that one.
Just nowhere to run, not a lot of wiggle room for the ball carrier.
This defense came in knowing that they had to match their physicality. Let's see if they can keep it up.
Got stuffed on first down. It's second and 10. Wants to throw. It's McConnell. Quickly complete. They'll pick up five. It'll be third and 5. Well, they made the grab, but the doors closed quickly after that.
And I like this. I want to find my running back. But, man, he's got to do a little more damage after the catch. I need a stiff arm. I need a spin move. I need something where he can make that guy miss and pick up a bunch of yards and maybe get a big play out of it.
Setting up the screen. And they wrap him up, but not before he gets enough on the catch for the first down. I was starting to think about what they would do if they didn't pick up the first down here, but I guess that's a moot point now.
Moot point for sure. And the head coach was probably telling them four down territory, we're going to kick a field goal, whatever the next decision was going to be. And now the OC is like, don't worry about it. New set of downs, nice execution by this offense.
He's going to pass. Buys a little time with his feet. Hit hard as he released the ball on that first down pass, and it never had a chance.
Yeah, and your first job is to affect the quarterback and try to get him off his spot. They get him off his spot, he gets outside the pocket, and a nice job chasing, not quitting, getting to the quarterback, and still getting a good lick as he's throwing the football.
After the quarterback and receiver failed to hook up, they'll try it again on second down. The aerial assault continues. Unloads to the wideout. And he's lucky to get that one back. This junior quarterback knows better than to try that too often. The timing on that throw and on the route was just convoluted and messed up from the beginning.
And you see quarterbacks and wide receivers in the offseason always working on timing and always working on throwing on air. But when you put a defense in front of them, now things start to speed up a little bit. A lot of times you'll see these little mistakes and where it looks like just they're not on the same page all the time.
On third down, he drops to throw. He's got his man. Moving deeper into enemy territory. Move the chains. It's first down at the 27.
Nice job by the running back there on that angle route against zone coverage. He wasn't in a hurry. He was able to sort of find the soft spot in the defense and just gear down, make himself an easy target.
Quickly out to the tight end. Puts him in the spinner and moves on. And he'll take it in and house it. Touchdown, UTEP.
number 87.
You want to talk about a great way to start the game and set the tone early.
It's so nice to have a quarterback just get himself into the game, get himself established. You make a couple throws, you lead your offense down the field, you score right off the bat. Could not have been a better start for that QB.
He'll start the return inside his five. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. The offense set for a first down play. Dropping back, it's Salter. And the defense makes a play, sacking him back at the 10.
This offense already in the black zone, a little bit backed up. How do they want to respond? They come out to throw the football, be aggressive, and this defense was ready, and they got pressure on the quarterback and got a sack on the very first snap.
Quickly complete. And they get to him and knock him down to prevent a big gain. They were able to make the completion, but he had to pick his way for just a little bit. Needed a little more help to spring him for some yardage.
Yeah, if you're going to have success when you throw it outside like that, you're going to need some more blocking and better blocking downfield. Give the defense credit, though. They were able to rally and made a tackle.
You make up the game plan and not a lot on the play sheet for this. Third and long from inside their own 20. And the pressure gets him back in the 8-yard line.
Really impressed with how this team has seized momentum here, playing on the road in this hostile environment. Their offense gets it first. They march down the field. They put up some points. And here's the defense now on their first drive, getting a critical sack on third down.
Can't hang on. He muffs it.
And that's got to be a big time break, because when you're a punt returner, you got all those guys flying down there and all those hands and all the speed on the field, it's hard to get back on the football. Nice job fumbling it. Not really, obviously, but a nice job recovering it.
UTEP has the ball, the offense ready to go back to work. Jesse looking to take it down the field for back-to-back touchdowns.
I think it's really important for them moving forward, too, to have a lot of balance, right? You want to be able to keep this defense guessing ball.
Yeah, and you got me searching for answers after that last drive. You stack another drive on top of this, their defense's heads are going to be spinning all over the place.
Looking for a crease. It's Jackson. And he's down at the 41. That's a first down.
And here we go. If you're an offense, you got to get that ground game going so you can have some balance, and then you give it to your quarterback, Palmer, and let him make some plays down the field later on.
Yeah, exactly. And you know, coming into this game, this offense knew they were going to have to some way, somehow, at least establish a semblance of a running game for exactly what you just said. You got to be able to use play action pass later in this game to get some explosive plays down the field. And it's a play like that that we just saw, which can help them get that going.
And now on second down for this offense. The give to the back. And a nice solid pickup there before the defense wrestles him to the ground.
And 5 to 6 yards a pop. I don't know if you guys are really good at math, but that usually equals a first down every couple carries. So don't forget about the run game. Keep them honest and pound that rock.
Finds a tight end. And this junior loves to show off that big arm.
Well, they pick up the first against zone coverage. I think a big part of this for young quarterbacks out there is if you're going to be throwing into zone coverage, you got to throw on time. You can't stare down receivers because the entire defense has their eyes on you, so you can't telegraph where the ball is going. You've got to hold it to the very last possible second. Try to freeze defenders with your eyes and then throw the ball into open areas of the field, anticipating where your guy's going to be.
Six-yard pickup on first down leaves him with second and four. Defense showing plenty of pre-snap movement of their own. Back to throw, it's McConnell. Pressure coming. It's complete to the left. Oh, the quick spin move. Oh, my, circle. Spinderella put him in the spin cycle and picked up the first down.
And guys, how many first downs is that? Just on this drive alone? I mean, this defense allows one or two more drives like this, and they're going to be gassed by the third quarter.
The Miners with the first and 10. Looking to move it through the air. And the physical play there forces the incompletion on first down.
Man, that's a big missed opportunity for the running back. I'm trying to find ways to feature this guy and get him the football in space and not just hand it to him all the time. And tell you what, I'm a lot less likely to find those plays if he can't reel in those catches.
After the misfire, now on second down. He's looking to throw. Get it out on the screen. He's run out of bounds, but a big play on that one, and it'll be a first down.
Great job, too, by the QB there, holding the ball as long as possible, allowing the pass rush to get upfield, and at the very last second, getting it to his guy so that he can go get the first down.
Out of the gun, the running back has it. Relying on the run, he gets a couple before he's knocked down. Ball's at the 13. Let's see what they've got on second down. Oh, this defense wants to bring some pressure. He's got it on the move. And he strides his way into the end zone. Touchdown, UTEP.
Defense has to be better on the back end. They knew this offense was going to come out, and they were going to challenge them. They were going to try to push the ball vertically down the field. They've now given up two touchdown passes in this game. They have got to shore up their play in the back half.
And the extra point makes it 14-0. The kickoff team on the field as they'll send this one away. No shot at a return. It's out of the end zone, and it'll be a touchback. They'll break the seal on this quarter here on first down. Wasting no time throwing on this drive. And the Heat will get home, and the quarterback goes down at the 17.
Well, I think one of the biggest reasons why this team is finding themselves in a hole here in the first half is this has been a sack party. They can't keep the defense off of their quarterback. They haven't been able to get the ball deep down the field, throwing it with the consistency they want.
And that pass intercepted. Couldn't find much room on the return, but what a costly miscue, and they've got it at the 26-yard line.
QB's got to pick and choose their spots when they want to be really aggressive and try to fit balls in tight windows. Great job by the DB making a big play, getting the ball back to its offense.
UTEP has the ball and the Miner offense ready to go to work. They've jumped on them, executing at a high level and up 14-0, David.
This is the exact start you want. I mean, offense is playing great. Defense has gotten stops. You're in a position now, Palmer, to put the hammer down and get a three-possession lead.
I'm really impressed with their physicality on both sides of the ball early in this one. They've been winning in the trenches. So here on offense, keep running the football and show your dominance.
To the air, it's McConnell. Quick strike complete. And they finally get him stopped, but it's a big throw and catch, and he's down at the 5. They built this offense around finding mismatches and just get the ball to the back and let him do his thing.
Yeah, it didn't have to be long down the field. Like, it threw it right near the line of scrimmage, but you know I got a guy, when he gets in space, he can make big plays happen. Nice decision by the QB.
Touchdown, Miners! And they made it to the house when they found that 6 points waiting on them. No step back in week three. They have been sharp as they extend the lead. And with the extra point, they push the lead out a little further. And let's check in with Kevin Connors in the studio. Kevin?
Boys, if it's happening in college football, we've got eyes on it. Check this out. Georgia State is in front. They've responded well to all the off-the-field chatter this week, but they still have to finish the job, and that is no sure thing right now. They're up by a field goal over Vanderbilt. We'll circle back if anything changes in this exciting college football matchup.
And how about that one? Kevin will be keeping an eye on everything going on elsewhere. Good, solid run on that one as he gets it up to the 33-yard line.
Well, and on these little push passes, timing is so important. You're trying to snap it right as he's getting a full head of steam. When he gets the ball, he's hitting the outside. And, David, it puts the defense in such a difficult spot.
You immediately have to be rotating when you see that motion. So everybody's got to communicate and kind of bump over. That's why offenses love to run it. Just it makes the defense communicate and see if you can just get him out of a spot.
Well, the defense knew coming into this one it was going to be a physical game. Guys are going to have to be great at the point of attack and get off blocks and make tackles. They couldn't stop the offense from picking up that first down on that one.
Hit hard just as he released it on first down and just couldn't get it to the receiver.
Man, the defense smells blood in the water. You can tell they're getting to this quarterback over and over and over. They've already sacked him a couple times. They're just winning up front. They almost got another sack on that last play.
Back to throw, it's Salter. Quarterback extends the play. And it's picked off.
This is obviously not a great start for this quarterback here. Two interceptions already in this game. He's got to do a much better job with his decision making.
UTEP has the ball, the offense ready to go back to work. This has been exactly the way you draw things up, David. The offense has really been moving the football.
And it's been great execution. They've done exactly what they've wanted to do. Build the lead. Now Palmer's a different animal. Now you got to protect it.
You can tell they were paying attention in practice this week in the film room because they have gone out everybody right now on the same page.
And that defense pushing him out of bounds after a short game.
And that's a really good job by this defense because remember, when the quarterback runs, now you got an extra blocker because he's not just handing it off and standing there. And they still did a good job at the point of attack, kind of strung it along and made him run out of bounds.
Offense gets set for second down. He's looking to throw. Can't make the grab. Quarterback just missed him a little bit. After the second down misfire, looking at a third and eight. From the gun, wants to pass. And they can't make the play on third down.
And those are tough passes. When you start throwing those balls towards the sidelines, it's a longer throw for the quarterback to make. And I think that's when you see the majority of the misses for guys, the majority of the overthrows and a little bit of inaccuracy start to show itself.
Pretty solid coverage there, and they'll stop him at the 26. Liberty takes over the Flames, sending the offense back onto the field. They've taken three haymakers right across the jaw, down 21-0. But, David, now the chance to answer.
Man, this defense has been suffocating. And this is so hard. When you don't have the answers early, man, and the defense hits you in the mouth, you got to find some plays quickly here to try to make this a football game.
This is an offense that has a lot of pride. They're not used to being in this position. I think it's going to take one effort, one individual great play to finally wake this team up and get them back some momentum.
To the air. It's Salter. Got his man quickly. Turns it on at midfield. Big, big gain on that one as he steps out of bounds with a first down.
Well, after that last play, you can see how electrifying this guy is and how special he is after he makes the catch. If I'm on offense, I'm trying to find a lot of ways to get him touches in this game.
They think there's room to run to the right here. He's brought down, but there's a flag on the field. Let's see which way that's going to go. So the decision has been made, and the coach will take the penalty. We've reached the two-minute warning, and this thing has been one-sided, and they hope to at least have something to feel good about going into halftime. First down here for the offense.
Let's go!
Wants to go up top. Flips it out to the back. And oh, did they know that one was coming? They'll knock him down in the backfield.
Well, there was really nowhere to go for the quarterback with that football. He's just trying to check it down to his running back, and the defense was there, and they made the play.
And here comes the offense on second down. He's looking to throw. I'm not positive, but that first down marker might be in the next county. On third and long, doesn't need to take the check down. He turns it loose to the left. And he's got it inside the 20.
And how about the big strike down the field? I love when offenses take shots down the field, try to make big plays. Now they're set up in the red zone.
Ready. Finally, this offense starting to shake the cobwebs and get things moving. It's first and 10. Trying to get to him. Just about picked off in the end zone, and that would have put a stop to this scoring threat. Instead, it'll be second down. Couldn't make the connection last time. Let's see if they throw it again. Quarterback checking off. Looking to throw, it's Salter. Escapes trouble. Oh, he needs to get rid of it. He needs to do something, and he will go down. What a terrible, terrible play and a big loss.
Ready?
Seventh play of the drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Looking to throw, and he needs a bunch. And he was hit just as he released it, and it falls to the turf.
Nice job by the defense. They're mixing up their look there. Third and long in field goal range, they go zone coverage. So everybody on the back end has the eye on the quarterback, and they're able to break on the ball, force the incompletion.
Fourth down, and the punt team sends it the other way. Wanted to make sure not to give them a chance for a return as it goes out of bounds. Up here, Jesse. Wonder how aggressive they're willing to be.
I think it's going to come down to how much confidence they have in this quarterback and his.
Nothing but green ahead. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. And they'll do more than move the chains. They'll move that thing more than 30 yards down the field before he's finally stopped.
And that's good enough for a first down.
Time dwindling away as they try to put points on the board right before the half.
Easy. Belly stutter. Go, go.
Looking to pass inside the red zone. Pass is incomplete, and half comes to a close on that play. That's going to wrap up the first half here, and now we join Kevin with the halftime update.
We'll be right back.
the Miners will kick it off to start the second half. On the run from inside his own five. Nice job executing all of the assignments as they put a stop to that return at the 22. Liberty takes over and the Flames offense ready to go to work. They come into this third quarter with a lot of work they need to get done.
Yeah, and it starts with this possession. And I'm going piece by piece. I know this is coach speaking, very simple. I score, I get a stop, I score, I can get back in this game, but it's got to be one drive at a time.
It's going to have to be, but I think the mindset offensively is we're probably going to have to score every time we get it because our defense has been struggling. They have not been getting a lot of stops, so this is a critical drive here for this offense.
Third down, and this offense is already in a world of trouble. They could really use a conversion, not to mention multiple scores. He'll pitch it. Still running at the 40. A tremendous run. He was full bore after taking that pitch. Just sweet execution. Okay, the Flames have it with a first and 10.
And they just kind of sneaked that one in there. As a defensive guy, third and 5+. I'm thinking pass. They were thinking pass, Palmer, and they slipped the run.
And it's so
and he breaks into the open. They'll make the stop, but not before they use the screen beautifully and pick up the first down.
And the offensive line and the quarterback has to do their job on screens. They got to sell pass down the field, pass down the field. Offensive line releases. Quarterback now snaps his eyes to the running back. The running back does the rest with the big boys out in front creating a pass.
Just couldn't find an open man. He'll get rid of it, and it'll be second down.
Good decision by the QB. You're outside the pocket. You're trying to find an open target. No one's open. Throw it away and live to play another day.
And the incompletion brings up a second down for this offense. Back to pass, it's Salter, feeling some heat. And the pass is incomplete, but the flag flies, and there was a lot of early contact there.
And the defender just way too handsy on that last play. You could see all the contact as the ball was in the air. He simply can't do it, and the referees caught it.
And the Flames are moving quickly down the field. The offense will have to use its first timeout of the half.
Timeout, Liberty.
The Flames have it in scoring position on first and goal.
Here we go.
The snap sets up the throw. Reels it in the end zone. Touchdown, Liberty.
And what a nice start for this offense. The throw game getting working. Getting the touchdown pass. This quarterback getting a little bit of confidence. This passing game getting in a rhythm. Nice start for this offense.
And for a quick update, let's go to Kevin Connors in the studio.
Guys, let's take a look at what's happening in a great college football matchup. Western Michigan is lighting up the scoreboard right now thanks to a dazzling offensive display. They're up by 21 over the Pandas. We'll circle back if anything big happens in this college football matchup.
Oh, and how about that? I know Kevin and those guys will be keeping an eye on it for us. UTEP has the ball, the offense ready to go back to work.
Easy. Gaucho.
He'll come out throwing on first down. He lofts it high and deep down the left side. And that'll be incomplete, man. That would have been a big hitter on first down, but second down's coming up.
And it's okay that that ball's incomplete. It's important this offense comes out and they show that they want to be aggressive. They show that they're willing to take shots and they're going to try and take the top off of this defense. Not able to connect on that one, but that will not be the last deep ball we see in this game.
They're bringing heat. Now moving to his right, looking for anyone that's open. They'll force him out of bounds after a solid pickup on the play.
Well, great job there by the defense because they weren't able to get him sacked right away, but you saw the coverage at the back end. Nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football. Didn't get the sack, obviously. You don't get the negative play, but you also don't give up a big one. You're feeling pretty good about where you are right now in this drive.
Back to pass. It's McConnell. Moving out of the pocket. Nothing open downfield, so he'll just toss it away.
Defense did a great job. Third and short on the opponent's side of the field. They're expecting quick throw. Everybody, they dug their heel on the ground. They're able to break on the ball, force the incompletion.
Not going to risk a return here. He'll make the fair catch. Liberty takes over the Flames, sending the offense back onto the field. They cut into the deficit the last time they had it, forced the punt, and now they can really make this a game.
And you're right back in this thing. You're creating some momentum. You got the score. You got the stop. This offense, Jesse, has a chance now to make this an absolute barn burner of a ball game.
Yeah, it's one play at a time, though, right? You're not going to get it all back in one play. Just go out, do your job, execute, keep this thing going down the field. And if things go well, like David said, we've got a game.
After the incompletion, they go back up top. He's got it down the left. Got a lot of running room. Touchdown, Flames. You thought they were done. They're not. They're back, baby.
And this receiver is on fire. He's got all the skills that you look for in a big-time target. That's already his second touchdown of the game.
And the PAT will draw them 1 point closer. This offense prides itself on going after you, and they did with that long touchdown pass to finish off a two-play drive. 14. The ball and the minor offense ready to go to work. They still have the lead here, Jesse, but this would be a good time to put together a drive.
You're right, Reese. You can't rest easy right now. You just watched the opponent drive down the field and score a touchdown of their own, so you've got to answer that here. Your playmakers better step up.
And I don't know what it is about momentum. In all the locker rooms and all the years, coaching, everything, you can't quantify it, you can't measure it, and the momentum has swung to the other side. You've got to get it back.
To the ground with the back. Couldn't find a lane, a pickup of one to the 31.
The run game just has not been working for this offense all game long. You saw it on that last play as well. Just not getting enough push up front on the offensive line. They haven't been physical.
Fires to the tight end. And he's down after making the catch, but did not reach the line to gain.
One of the things I love about this defense is they just have such great awareness, and they're always communicating. They understood the down and distance. They knew exactly what they needed to do to make the tackle to force the punt. That is so well done.
In their own territory, no problem. Fourth and inches, and they'll go for it. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. And the incomplete pass lets this defense get the ball back for its own great field position.
And they decide to go for it. They decide to be aggressive, try to throw the football down the field. Receiver, quarterback, not on the same page. No dice, turnover on downs.
Looking for a man. It's Salter. Finds his man down the middle.
Great job creating space. That's what you're supposed to do. When you get man coverage, you got to find a way to get a step, make it easy for your quarterback to read that leverage. And when he drags across the field, he can see he had him. He completes it for the first down.
And the Flames pick up the first down.
And I don't care if I get it by 2, by 20, by 30, by 40. I just want to get the first down, understanding the situation, understanding where the sticks are. Doesn't have to be sexy, but I got to make sure I get to that stick, get to the first down mark.
looking to go up top on first down. And it's picked off for the third time today. And they'll close in on him after a good return on the interception.
Timing has to be so good. When you're throwing at his own defense over the middle of the field, the ball's got to come out specifically on time because these windows close really quickly. Ball there thrown a little bit late. As a result, it's an INT.
UTEP has the ball, the offense ready to go back to work. These last couple of drives, Jesse, have been about the defense making clutch stand.
I think for this offense, they can stay aggressive knowing that their defense is going to bail them out time and time again here.
Yeah, and especially when you go for those fourth down situations, you do that a lot of times because you know your defense can make stands, make stops. They did on that last possession.
Now on second down after the incompletion. We'll see if this offensive line is ready for the blitz. He wants to throw here on second down. That pass is incomplete, and they might be fortunate it wasn't knocked free for a fumble. It'll be third down. They line up, and it is a long way to the sticks from here. To the air, it's McConnell. And the catch along the sideline will come up a little short of the first down. Man, you have to do everything in your power not to let your momentum carry you out of bounds short of the first down marker.
And I would argue, too, maybe you run your route a little bit deeper. You got to understand where the first down marker is and where I got to get to. But yeah, I'm not running out of bounds. I'm lowering my shoulder and trying to get as much yardage as I can to make this fourth down manageable.
Corners are going to bail. Quick timeout call by the offense after the play.
Timeout, UTEP.
A couple of yards shy of the first down marker, but they've decided this is four down territory. The offense still on the field. What a snag by the defense. Taking it the other way. He's at the 10. And he has taken it all the way back. Touchdown, Liberty. This time it's the defense finding ways to put points on the board.
There is nothing better than being a defender. Seeing that ball in the end zone, your eyes get big as saucers. Go jump on that puppy, secure it, get you a touchdown.
All tied up, just about set to kick it away. UTEP has the ball and the Miner offense ready to go to work. The big thing now, don't get rattled by that last pick six, David.
Nah, it was a big mistake. Obviously, the defense took advantage of it, but you got to put it behind you. Jesse, I'm sure you know a thing or two about throwing a pick six and how to rebound.
I believe I've only thrown one in my life, but yes, I do, because of that singular instance. I'll say this. You can't let that play beat you twice. You got to go out, not try to get it all back here in one play. Just execute the offense.
Not what they had in mind to start this drive. Here comes second and 13. Back to throw, it's McConnell. And that is good versatility there, and a big hit from the backer in pass coverage. A third down play to open up this quarter. He'll set up to throw. They're trying to get to him. Fires to the big fella. And he'll get it up to the 38. It'll be a first down. No reason to panic when you see those extra bodies coming. Just find the big tight end.
Well, and the great ones do that. The great ones are okay. You want to blitz? I know my answers. I'm all right. I'll stay patient. Find the matchup. This time it was the tight end. Finds the tight end, throws a strike, gets the first down.
From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. Creating some space, getting just enough good blocking, and they've got it up to the 47-yard line.
Coaches always harp about staying ahead of the chains, and when you can run with that type of efficiency on first down, man, you are doing just that.
After the 9-yard pickup on first down, here's second and one. D looks as if they're about to bring the heat. On second down, looking to throw. Caught behind the line, it's Jackson. The defense wouldn't let him loose, and even though it's a completion, they lost yardage.
Love the play by the defense. They just did a good job understanding where the running back was on that play. After the catch, they're able to make the tackle right away, and now they've set up third down.
He's looking to throw on third and short. Finds his tight end. And the defense makes the immediate tackle, but he has enough for the first down. Love the way he didn't just run to a spot. He found the cushion in the zone and got himself open for the first down.
Yeah, and you're taught to find that space. Don't run right into a zone defender who's sitting there looking at the quarterback and looking at you. So much creativity with routes now and being able to just have subtle moves one way, come back the other way. Nice job by the tight end finding that hole in the zone.
Trying to find his man on first down. He's taking the shot. And they won't make the connection, looking to make a big play there.
Nice job by the defense there, taking all throws away from the quarterback. He had nowhere to put that football in the field to play, so that ball obviously had to go out of bounds.
After the incompletion, it's second down. On the run, it's McConnell. It's caught. Giving him his pads. They are finding soft spots in this defense. He's got it down to the 25.
Well, it's a nice play design there. You're getting the running back involved in the pass game. Quarterback gives it to him early so he can go to work upfield and get the first down.
Maybe this will breathe a little life into this offense, which has been flatlined in the second half. Here's first and 10. They'll run it from the gun. Hard running there. Nowhere to run on that when he loses 4 on the carry.
Not just do you get to make a big play on defense, but it's also a TFL, tackle for loss. Doesn't get better than that.
His drive was clicking along, but now it's second and 14. Easy. He's looking to throw. A little screen to the running back.
Dances away again.
They're able to get him stopped just shy of the first down mark.
Yeah, and you see running backs in today's football, they play a lot of receiver basically for you, but you got to find a guy that you can throw it to, and you know he's going to catch the ball consistently.
They've been really good moving the chains on third down. Now 1 yard away from another first down on this drive.
Griffin!
Looking to throw for it. Quick completion on the out route. They didn't get a ton of yardage there, but they're really effective at using the back out of the backfield, and they do it to get the first down here. They were able to get the ball to the running back in space, but that space just evaporated.
And a great job by the defense, man. It's tough to get those guys on the ground. They're so used to being having the football as running backs and making plays and being dynamic. So usually one guy not going to get into the ground. You want many guys swarming to the football, trying to get that elusive guy on the ground.
The Miners have it with a first and 10. Looking for a physical attack from the gun. He'll be brought down at the 5 yard line, and this defense is on its heels. The defense uses their second timeout of the half as they try to get their act together. Operating in the red zone here on second down. On the move. He works his way all the way down to the 3, and the defense is reeling. Defense calls a quick timeout there, perhaps a little confusion about what call they were in. Tight quarters deep in the red zone, but they can't pick up a first down without scoring. Third down. Defense loves to show heat and try to confuse the quarterback. That just never had a chance as they controlled the middle of the field and stopped him in the backfield on third down.
All right, fourth and short. You need a field goal to take the lead. There's less than a minute left right now. I don't think you get aggressive here on fourth down. Just kick the field goal to give yourself a chance to win this game.
Liberty takes over, and the Flames offense ready to go to work. A pretty good bit of ground to cover here, Jesse, but they've got some time to work with.
They do. So tempo is going to be important. You got to go fast. You just got to make good decisions at the quarterback position.
And those good decisions are throwing the ball beyond the sticks, using the sidelines to get out of bounds, trying to maximize this time and get in a position to win.
Sprinting to the line to try to get this one off. Clock's running. They'll throw it on first down. Gets it out fast.
I think in this situation, 2 minutes, trailing late, I think you got to be throwing to the sticks every time. I don't know if these short completions are going to get it done. You're just not going to have enough time to get down the field. So from a play calling standpoint, I think you want to think about being a little bit more aggressive.
Looking to throw, it's Salter. Wiggles free. That pass is incomplete, and they're probably fortunate that it wasn't knocked free for a fumble.
Great job of timing the blitz and calling it at a perfect moment when the offense was going to drop back and throw. They're able to get to him, hit him. They don't get the sack, but they do affect his accuracy, and the ball's incomplete.
Okay, right. Third and short from the 44, and we might know if they plan to go for it on fourth down by what they call here. Quarterback checking the play. Out of the shotgun on third down. Quarterback adapting. And he can't find anyone open, and down he goes. The defense will take a timeout. 25 seconds left to play. The Flames send out the punt unit. He's going to try to flip the field with this one. A fairly short distance here toward the sidelines. Not his best work.
Return goes out of bounds.
Some ground to cover here, David, if they're going to try to get in position to win this game in regulation.
Yeah, and you practice this every week. This is the moment in practice, the two-minute drill. Get as much as you can. Rush the field goal unit on. Jesse, you better be prepared for this moment.
And, David, this is exactly what quarterbacks live and play for. You're now in a position to go win this thing for your team.
Offense getting set for first down. Scanning the field, it's McConnell. Going to try to pop one on the screen. And it's pretty obvious there was a big hole in that screen and the defense ran right through it. And they're trying to dig out of the hole on second and long from the 9. He's looking to throw. Receiver shows motion. Quick pass on the fly motion. And the defense stops him just short of the first down. Maybe needed a few more chain links to move the sticks. And with that one, he's now over 3 bills for the game.
And there's two reasons why, Reese. He's made good decisions, and he's been accurate throwing the football all game long.
Quarterback wants to throw on second down. Makes the grab down the middle. And this junior quarterback shows you why the scouts love that big arm of his.
Ever since they invented the forward pass, the tight ends have been running the drag and getting the first down.
I think it's because the tight ends is so much versatility. You know, they can block and stay in the formation, or they can release and come out. But either way, the quarterback's patient most of the time. That drag route's going to come in.
Picked up some of what they needed on first down. Now it's second and goal from the 5.
4-2 Spider.
Defense showing blitz. Will they bail out of it? Touch pass on the run. And he'll take this into the end zone, but hang on just a second. Flag down. Let's see what this is about. The officials offer the deal, and the coach accepts it. They will take the penalty. Looking for a crease to the left. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
And the offense, they're just trying to be physical. They're trying to run this ball in damn close to the goal line. The defense, though, they're having none of it.
On third and long, he's going to have to turn one loose downfield. No siree, not this time. The defense was there and ready for that one. So they'll send out the field goal team to try to take the lead here in overtime. Not a chance. Missed it. After that failed field goal attempt, fellas, still tie ball game. First down, and they'll win it with any kind of score here in overtime.
Jackrabbit.
The give from the gun. And this one will be stopped for no gain.
Everybody talks about DBs. They talk about dropping coverage and not being physical. That DB begs to differ. Great tackle coming up, playing physical like a linebacker.
Double right.
Right back to it. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
And not much running room. He had to break a tackle and still break another tackle to try to get back to the line of scrimmage. Not good blocking on the play.
Well, that's what coaches always emphasize, too. Never assume a teammate's going to make the tackle. You run to the ball, and they did it there.
100%, especially guys that are so big and strong and elusive nowadays. They're going to break tackles. Keep swarming, keep hitting them. Okay, next guy, don't assume the tackle's going to be made.
Third and long, and they don't want to move backwards to make sure they have a chance to kick an easy one and win it in OT. Power football with the run. And sure, tackling there to keep him from getting to the first down marker. So here we go, a long field goal attempt to win it. And he got it! The kick is good! Wins the game in overtime!
I know how to sum up this game succinctly. That was fun, and what a victory to remember.
Fun for them, fun for us, just the back and forth, games that are so nip and tuck, and you know every play matters so much. These are the games that we love to call.
Yeah, every play matters, David, and that's why coaching staffs practice overtime scenarios and situations throughout the week. It's important to drill these types of scenarios. You never know what games are going to go to OT, and when they do, you love to be able to go out and execute with the game on the line.
That's going to do it for us from here. For Jesse Palmer, David Pollack, I'm Reese Davis, and this has been another presentation of EA Sports College Football.